fairly all right for a country like ours, you know, 3.5% last year compared to our friends in Europe. 3% is actually pretty good, but it is on the rise. The main thing I think is graduate unemployment, and that's really important when you're talking about an educated population. It's 24%. That's like a quarter of all our graduates coming out of universities not having a job. Retrenchments. I don't know if many of you take Uber or Grab these days, but you'll find that all of your Uber and Grab drivers have been retrenched, many of whom are from the oil and gas sector. I think over the last 2 years itself, we've got close to like 70, 80,000 people out of jobs. And you might think that these are blue-collar workers, but that's not necessarily true. More than half of them are skilled, and almost 20% are actually of managerial level. So you're talking about managers who are getting out of a job. What are these people doing? Where are they in the labor market out there? Are they... Some of them are lucky they have cars, they can become Uber drivers, but if you don't have a car, what actually are your options? And 6,000 public university lecturers lost their jobs last year. This is also related to the cut in budget that the government has done over the last 2 years. Public universities are facing huge problems. We just completed a project on higher education in Malaysia, and universities are now scrambling to have to try and raise their own funds. They're going into things like becoming tourist agents, and like, you know, universities are not meant to become tourist agents. They're not. That's not their main job. Okay, number three. I'm not sure how many of you are in business sector, and I think sometimes people like us tend to forget about business owners. I think the SMEs are finding it more and more difficult to run businesses. In 2014, just 3 years ago, Malaysia ranked quite high in the World Bank Doing Business report, sixth, and now we're ranked at the 23rd place, so dropped by, you know, more than 10 places. I speak a lot to business owners and associations, and I find more and more that they're facing, you know, increasing red tape, what they call hidden costs in doing business. What hidden costs really means is that you gotta pay. You gotta pay under the table money, and there's lots of layers that you have to go through. And this applies, by the way, not just at the federal level, but at the state level, local council level. And sad to say, Selangor is not an exception as well. So this, I think, needs to be relayed on to our friends in the opposition. There's things like, you know, the implementation of GST, compliance costs that companies need to deal with. There's a newly introduced tourism tax. How many of you read about this? It's going to be implemented on the 1st of July. It's really silly, but I think what the government is trying to do is actually to target our Airbnb and some of these homestay facilities. But the point is that it's going to increase the burden on the point about all these taxes and hidden costs is not going to hit the big boys. Your big hotels, your big companies, they can survive, no problem. They're MNCs, they can pull out from KL, go to some other country in the region and survive. What you're going to hurt is actually the smaller and medium companies. People like you, some of you may run companies. I mean, my mom runs her own company. And these SMEs are the ones that actually are going to be hit the most. Number four, okay, we talk about grand corruption, right? Mega scale corruption, 1MDB and all that. There's also corruption at the smallest levels where people have factories, they want to build their own buildings, but then they have to pay like 20-30% more simply because they have to pay off certain people. Bribes, you know, getting tenders. Malaysia fell in the Transparency International CPI score this year. That's no surprise. Well, it's harder for us because one of our projects is actually to try and increase that. But, you know, it's actually falling. And then, of course, there's a lack of information, lack of transparency on government websites. Issue number five, 1MDB, yes. But I think more important than 1MDB is that 1MDB is a GLC, right? It's a government-linked company. Or in international terms, they call it SOE, state-owned enterprise. What does this mean? It means that if 1MDB, a crisis like 1MDB could have happened, how many other GLCs out there are there that have not yet been you know, put under the microscope and found to be wanting in terms of its books, in terms of it of its debts, and more importantly, these debts actually are going to come back to the generations of Malaysia from here onwards. You know, don't think that these companies lose money, okay lah, that's it, you know, the money has gone elsewhere. The money is being paid back from the government coffers, by the way, and this puts a burden on our children and our grandchildren. GLCs, do you know, this is interesting, nobody knows how many GLCs there are in Malaysia. We've spoken to people in government, especially in Ministry of Finance, because MOF has the most number of GLCs. You ask them and they say, oh, actually we don't know, nobody has done a list. and the reason is this, many ministries have their own GLCs, they set up their own companies, and those companies set up their own companies, and those companies set up their own companies, so, you know, the line goes all the way down. I mean, you're talking about like 10 layers down, and even then it's so hard to keep track. Not to mention